Hey guys, it's Alyssa. So you're gonna see this outfit in like a little bit. So I was cleaning out some footage and I deleted the intro. So yeah, this is actually 2 days later from the footage I'm about to put in. But basically, I think I talked about. I don't even really know what I was talking about. Yeah, I wish I hadn't deleted that. But this vlog was gonna be me doing my like studio art courses at home since, you know, coronavirus. And what I last filmed, so what you're about to see, I was shooting for my photo class and I had to do 3 self-portraits that were like in some way connected to like sort of our response, I guess, to, all the craziness right now. We had 3 prompts. One was, you had to use an object. The second one was, something significant about like the space you were shooting in. And then the third one was using lighting to tell us a story or, like, to, I guess, to reveal something about the person you're shooting. Because next week, I have to shoot someone in my family or, like, someone I'm sheltering in place with. But first, we had to do self-portraits, and I shot all these the day they were due. That's kind of why the footage is a little bit rushed at that point. But, yeah, so just keep watching for that. Oh, I guess I'll give you, in case you've, you know, never seen me before, especially because I have not used this channel in a hot minute. I'm a studio art major with a concentration in photography. You can't, like, just major in one discipline. You have to, yeah, you get the idea. So that's why I put a lot of effort into my photo stuff, because that's kind of what I want to do. But yeah, so let's get into it. Okay, so the first shot is the object one, and all this is basically supposed to have something to do with us, like, this is sideways, I'm sorry, like, with the whole, you know, current, like, quarantine or whatever situation, the shelter-in-place kind of stuff. So for the object one, I was trying to think of something that, like, is relevant to right now, like, so I'm using my phone, which, in any other circumstance, I feel like it could be, like, really cringy to use your phone and, a photograph, but, I feel like right now, it's the only way that I'm still keeping up with people, and, it's, like, all this would be so different if we didn't have technology, because, like, I don't feel like I've been, like, totally cut off from people, because I have, like, Instagram and Snapchat and, like, texting and all that, so, yeah, so I'm gonna use my phone. I'll probably shoot some with this side showing and some with this. Well, not my messages, but, like, with just the blank screen. But also, like, I'm kind of afraid stuff will reflect on it. But I also don't want the back to be, like, distracting or whatever. But, and then I think I'm gonna have my headphones in, so it's not, like, just object and, like, me, so there's, like, some kind of connection or whatever. And also, like, I mean, any time I can, like, tie in music, I guess, like, that's kind of cool, because I like music. Yeah, I'm not, like, in love with any of my ideas for this. The space one will be easy, because I'm just using my room, but, for this one, it took me forever to think of anything, and I was like, well, this is, like, honestly the most, like, non-cheesy, like, relevant thing I can bring in. Like, if I brought my Switch in, that would be weird. Like, even though I've been playing Animal Crossing a lot, like, I'm not about to do that, so, yeah, we'll see how this goes. So I'm gonna use my tripod. This is gonna be weird to set up because I kinda wanna be like laying on the bed so I can just like lay the phone next to me, not be like, but if you care about what equipment I'm using, let's see, this is, I don't know, I'm not big on gear, but this Manfrotto tripod, it's nice, cause especially like, this part is like nice for like moving around and stuff, which will help for this. And then my camera is the Canon 70D. If you like know anything about me, or like have watched my videos, I don't know. I prefer shooting film, but for school, it's pretty much all digital at this point. I have like one more film class, but I don't get to take it till my last semester, so. I'm just using like the kit lens, the 18 to 55 millimeter. Okay, here's how the setup's looking. I've got my camera on a tripod up here. I'm hoping I can like somehow lay in between there and there, and then I got my phone. And then I'm gonna use this remote so that I can like activate it and not have to like actually reach up to the camera. Okay, so I finished that first shot. I don't really know where I'm gonna put these in the vlog, but I probably will at some point. So either I've already put it in or I'll put it in at the end, we'll see. But next I'm doing the one with like the environment of the room or whatever. So I wanna get like this like section of my room, so I'll probably sit on my bed, and then I think I'm gonna set my tripod up like at an angle, kinda down, shooting up, so we'll see how that works. So I'm currently taking a coffee break, even though it's like almost 2 o'clock, but also I'm trying to figure out what I'm gonna do for the third portrait, so I'm doing a little bit of research, see if I can get any ideas. But yeah, I'll get back to you when I have some progress. It's been a few hours, and I figured out what I'm gonna project. I'm gonna do, some photos I took, like, on trips. They're all except for one from last summer, but and then I wrote a little explanation thing. Yeah, so I made this little collage thing, and okay, I'm gonna have to like charge this. I've tried multiple times to charge this and it didn't. But I'm going to shoot for the same photo class, but basically we just had like for the last 3 weeks, this is literally the last day of this. We had to, this is like the worst time for me to choose to do this when I'm like trying to back out. We had to shoot for like 3 weeks, sort of like in response, I guess, to you know, sheltering in place or whatever. So a lot of it I shot in the house, but the thing is, like, 3 weeks of shooting in my house is kind of hard. So I'm kind of just gonna drive around and see if there's anywhere I can shoot. I've kind of, like, I've gone to a couple parks, but yeah, I'll insert some photos here, so I'm not just, like, trying to describe all this, but I've sort of gone back and forth between doing, like, things that look like multiple exposures with windows, and so, like, you couldn't really tell what was, like, inside the store window and, like, what was outside, or, like, at my house, it was more like what was in the backyard and, like, what was inside, like, kind of, like, blending the interior and the exterior is basically what I'm saying. That was the main kind of thing I was doing, and then it's been hard to keep doing that for 3 weeks, so some of it's just been like playing with light and shadow and stuff, so nothing like super amazing, but you know, we gotta get the grades in. So okay, so now, kind of like I said at the beginning of this, it's actually 2 days later, it's Easter Sunday, so happy Easter. Yeah, so like I said, now I'm working on a metal sculpture. This is what we have so far. Oh, this is gonna be so hard to show. Basically I have, oh, this is like beauty stuff, let's see. So you can see I have the outline of the head, but he's flat, so I need to fix that. But like the rest of him is, it's just a dude sitting on a skateboard. We had to do some kind of figurative narrative. And I wanted the person to be sitting down to make my life easier and getting, because you couldn't have like a person who's supposed to be standing but then it like falls over, is like leaning against something. This way it stands on its own. And it's taken me, I've probably spent like 6 hours on it so far, and the average amount of time we were supposed to spend on this is like 9. Actually it may have been more than 6 hours at this point, but yeah, so I have one more foot that has to get done, and then the head. And then from there, it's just gonna be like fine-tuning, I guess, and if I want to add any details. So I will get back to you. Okay, here's my progress. Basically, how he's looking now, I would be okay turning it in. I have 2 more days before I have to, like, submit photos of it or whatever, so, yeah, I may put in some more work, but here's some detail shots. The cool thing about the hat is, like, it actually comes off. But, that was mostly just for convenience in making it. But yeah, I think he turned out pretty good. The knees, this area is a little bit, I'm not a big fan of, like, all this. but I feel like the shirt, like, the upper body turned out pretty good. I thought the head was gonna be too big, and it is a little bit big, all things considered, but, you know, it came together. But, like, all this in here, I think, actually looks pretty cool, and this is kind of hard to, like, show on camera. And then, like, you can see the little skateboard at the bottom. But yeah, overall, I'm pretty excited about him. The purpose of this was for it to be like a 3D line drawing, just so you get an idea of where the assignment was coming from. What up? So I'm taking a quick snack break. If you're wondering what I'm eating, I've got these Made Good granola balls. And then this is the same brand, but they're like these cookies. And, they're nice because, they don't have wheat in them. I don't eat wheat. But also, they're, like, made of, like, vegetables, so, but they don't taste like vegetables. So I don't feel, like, so bad eating them, you know? Because it is 10 o'clock at night. I don't normally like to eat this time. But, we eat dinner kind of early as a family, and, I stay up kind of late, so kind of hungry. But, yeah, so basically, I finished for now. Metal sculpture, I'm happy with it for the time being. And then, I decided I wanted to do, just for fun, like, a collage kind of thing. Similar to what I did for my projection, but just for fun with some of my, travel photos. So I've been getting together some letters to spell out the names of a few of the places. I'm probably gonna only do, like, one or two, like, right now and see how it happens, or how it goes. And then, because I kind of, like, part of me wants to make it, like, physically and scan it in, but also, like, it wouldn't be that hard to do it in Photoshop, so I'm like, I don't know, but I haven't really done any kind of, like, projects just for myself in, like, months, so I was like, this would be kind of fun. But yeah, we'll see. I might get a little bit done tonight, because I still need to, like, shower and stuff. But yeah. Okay, so it's been, a couple hours? No, it's been like an hour and a half. It's like 10, I think, when I sat down. And I finished one, like, I might do more tomorrow or something, but as far as, like, testing it out, I'm done for now. So, this is what we've got. So, those are the, bead letters I was, taking photos of, and I just, like, cut them out. And then, as far as, like, the photos, I used some, like, actual torn paper, and I guess made, like, masks is what they're called. I'm not really good with, like, what things are called. But you can see, like, I, like, would cut them out and do, like, the... that is a mask, right? Isn't that a mask? Yeah, add a mask, okay. And then I would just do the thing where you, like, hold down option and this, like, goes into it. I don't know. I know how to do these things, but I don't know what anything's called. But, yeah, that's that. So I think I'm going to take a shower in a second. Yeah.